Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with debugging the Syncfusion Blazor source code using the source code add-on. Syncfusion provides a source code add-on installer that allows you to modify the Syncfusion source code and use customized assemblies and NuGet packages. Now, let me proceed to show you how to debug the Syncfusion Blazor source code. To do that, first, I need to install source code add-on installer. If you want to know more about the source code add-on installer, click the video link shown in the YouTube card above. Once the installation is completed, the Syncfusion Blazor source code will be available in the following location. To debug the Syncfusion Blazor source code, you can use two options. One is with the Syncfusion Blazor single source package, and other is with an individual package source. First, I am going to show you how to debug using the Syncfusion Blazor single source package. This package contains all the components in a single source file and allows you to debug them with a single project file. Now, let me create a Blazor server project named Blazor App with default.NET 6.0 framework. After the app creation, add the Syncfusion Blazor project by choosing the existing project option from this location to the newly created application. Also, I need to add this Syncfusion Blazor project reference under the dependencies section. Next, I will open the program.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I will register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the add Syncfusion Blazor method. Next, I need to refer the script and theme for the Syncfusion Blazor source in the layout.cshtml file. Now, everything is configured. To debug the Blazor calendar source, open the index.razor component and add the Syncfusion Blazor calendar's namespace by replacing the default code. Then, define the Blazor calendar component with the tValue property as dateTime. Next, I will open the SF calendar's razor file under calendars folder and keep the breakpoint within the onInitialized method. Now, I will run this example by pressing the key F5. Look, the output page opens and the breakpoint hits the source. When you click the next function called button, it moves to the next code. Or, you can also click resume execution button to render the calendar component. Now, I will move on to the Syncfusion Blazor individual package source that contains only the specified source in that package name to reduce the application deployment size in production. If you want to know more about the benefits of the individual package source, you can refer to the UG page link shown in the above YouTube card. Now, I will move on to show you how to debug the individual source package. I will create another Blazor server application in Visual Studio with .NET 6 framework. When creating the project, please do not install any Syncfusion Blazor-related packages to the application, since you are debugging using the source code. Then, I will add the individual package source reference to the Blazor application. I navigate to the location which contains the individual source code folders. I am going to use the calendar component source code, therefore, I add the Syncfusion Blazor calendars project reference to the application under the dependencies section. I also need to add themes project to the Blazor app and include this project reference in the reference manager window. If you want to debug the button component source in the calendar component source, remove the existing buttons package reference from the Syncfusion Blazor calendar project. Then, go to the Syncfusion Blazor buttons folder and add the Syncfusion Blazor buttons project file reference to the calendar's source project. Next, I will open the program.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I will register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the add Syncfusion Blazor method. Next, I need to refer the script and theme for the Syncfusion Blazor source in the layout.cshtml file. Now, everything is configured. To debug the Blazor calendars source, open the index.razor component and add the Syncfusion Blazor calendars namespace by replacing the default code. Then, I will define Blazor calendars component with the tValue property as dateTime. Next, I will open the SF calendars razor file under calendars folder and keep the breakpoint within the onInitialized method. Now, I will run this example by pressing the key F5. Look, the output page opens and the breakpoint hits the source. When you click the next function called button, it moves to the next code. Or, you can also click Resume Execution button to render the calendar component. Finally, I will show you how to debug the JavaScript files in the Syncfusion Blazor source code add-on. As a first step, I navigate to the Syncfusion Blazor source code add-on installed location. Then, open the command prompt and run the command npm install to install the packages. Next, I will run the command set node underscore env equals development to set the development environment. After setting the environment variable, run the gulp bundle and ngulp bundle single script command to generate the single script file and individual script files under the Syncfusion Blazor www root folder. Now, I will run the Blazor application and the output page opens with the Blazor calendars component. To debug the Syncfusion Blazor JavaScript files, first, I need to open the developer tools window and click the source tab. Here, Syncfusion Blazor min.js file opens under the scripts section. I have kept the breakpoint here and then reload the page. When you click the next function called button, it moves to the next code. Or, you can also click Resume Execution button to render the calendar component. Let me recap what we have seen in this video. We have seen how to debug the Syncfusion Blazor single source package and individual source package. We also saw how to debug the Syncfusion Blazor JavaScript files using the Syncfusion Blazor source code add-on. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.